Skin-tight spandex, raucous head-banging, screeching vocals. We could only be talking about one thing. No, it's not my grandmother. No, it's heavy metal, folks, and today's topic is the best heavy metal band of all time. Now, here's how it works. Each of our celebrity guests has brought their top three picks. They'll all slash away at each other defending those choices before letting our audience vote on the definitive top three heavy metal bands of all time. I'm Joe Rogan, this is VH1, and you are on the list. Let's meet our panel. Nobody knows heavy metal better than our first guest. He's the former lead singer of Judas Priest. Please welcome the legendary Rob Halford. Welcome, sir. Welcome. You may know our next guest as Judge Julie from Playboy's TV Sex Court, the very foxy Miss Julie Strain. Wonderful ensemble you've chosen. And our next guest is a very talented lead singer of Rat. Please hear a huge applause for Stephen Piercy. All right, our final guest is the former head of new media at Maverick Records and is currently the president of M80 Interactive Marketing. Please welcome Dave Newpert. All right, we're about to hear who our panelists have chosen as the best heavy metal bands of all time. But before we get to those picks, let's take a look at what some of you had to say about metal.
Heavy metal.
Are we cool? That's heavy metal.
Take a ride on the wild side.
Heavy metal screaming!
Metallica, that's where it's all at, dude.
Heavy metal, it's totally insane!
Don't go crazy, no! Yeah!
Heavy metal rules, rock and roll! Woohoo!
All right. All right. All right. It's time to get to our guest choices. Mr. Halford, you, sir, first. What is your third choice?
My first choice in order of three is a band that was just recently at Woodstock, ripped everybody's face off. That was Rage Against the Machine.
Yeah.
You know, I like them because, for me, the list I've chosen kind of represents metal through the ages. And I think that what Rage represents now is a crossover between hard rock and metal and rap rock, you know, that is from Rage. You've got bands like Limp Bizkit and Kid Rock. Everybody sprung from that kind of springboard. And I also like him because if you're gonna be radical with your music, if you're gonna create a lot of power, a lot of reaction, like Burning the Flag and stuff like that, then you need to have some substance lyrically. So musically, they rip my face off, and they do the same with me lyrically.
That's
so
about Rage Against the Machine. Right. All right, man, good call. I agree with that wholeheartedly.
Yeah, cool.
All right, Julie, you, number three.
Oh,
what do you
okay.
got?
I think my number three choice, I'm going to have to pick Kiss, only because I remember riding home from high high school in this guy's black Camaro and seeing that 8-track coming out of the glove box with those shoes and makeup on, and I'm straddling the glove box running with this Hurst 4-speed rattling between my legs. Yes, so it has to be Kiss. That's my fondest.
What about James Bond?
That's a little more than I needed
well,
to know.
Yes. I fantasized about that when I got
home. I just got very nervous right there. 4-speed and the thing coming out of the glove.
Yes.
I got scared.
It was a hot memory. I can still smell the leather and the stuff in his car.
All right. I smell something too. All right. What did I say? All right, man. Steve, what's your third choice?
I picked Motorhead. Yeah. And it's because, third choice.
There's a couple of boos out there.
Well, whatever. I mean, Motorhead just. They're an ass-whipping kind of a band, you know, and Lemmy, I mean, come on, he's a freak, you know? He is the epitome of heavy, to me, heavy rock kind of thing.
Heavy rock kind of thing?
Whatever.
All right, dude.
Lemmy,
anybody
heavy
have a problem
metal.
With that? Anybody have a
he
problem
He likes it
Motorhead?
Because it has the word head in it. Motorhead.
Heavy mental.
No problems with that? You guys are all going to agree with each other, and it's going to be a sucky show.
No.
We just started.
Dave,
we just started.
What is your number three choice?
AC/DC, without a doubt.
That'll work.
It's, they pretty much started it all. They took heavy metal from where it was in the 70s, bridged the gap into the 80s. You know, Back in Black was a rite of passage album for every 13-year-old kid, and it still remains to be that. It's one of the albums that every kid has to have, no matter what. It's gonna take kids into the future. It's where Rage came from, it's where all these other bands came from.
Absolutely, dude. I just want to know how that dude doesn't have brain damage from that headbang.
Got banging his head
how
for 20.
How do you do that?
Anybody can bang their head for 25 years like that and still do it? And
I don't know how you do that. There's something wrong.
I think he just likes to see men playing guitars in shorts.
Oh my God. It's the schoolboy thing.
Is that what you think?
That's what I think.
Is that what you like?
Yeah, I like him wearing nothing, actually. But
you like him playing guitars with nothing?
Yeah. They don't even need their hands.
You don't want any mystery? No mystery?
Don't need the hands?
Well, that's a good thing.
If you're Gene Simmons, you don't need hands, right?
No. Oh, I see. A little
dumb. I'm Steven, Gene's Gene.
Okay, Rob, what is your second choice?
My second choice, they were up on the screen, Metallica. See, the thing about Metallica is that they're, you know, of the three bands I've chosen, the second band of Metallica, it's a band that's been able to make a long thing about the whole thing of metal.
Right.
And as we all know, metal will never die and it's going to be around forever.
We all know that?
We all know that. Yeah. Don't we know that?
Shit.
But the fact that they came from where they did with a very simple, direct form of metal, but complex in its arrangement, was a real shaker for a lot of people. It was like a thinking man's metal, if you will. For me, they represent a big portion of metal through the last almost 20 years, and
cool.
They do it for me, Metallica.
All right, Metallica. All right, Julie, what's your number two?
Oh, my number two happens to be Judas Priest. I've always had a secret crush on Rob here. And
really?
I'd love to give him a kiss.
Oh, what's going on? This isn't in the script. Oh, wow. Look at that.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
And that's why.
That's why?
The man turns me on.
Okay. I do?
Yeah.
Cool.
He's tall and lean and wears black, and he's a machine.
All right. And you like his music, too, right?
Oh, yeah.
And we only just met, 5 minutes ago. So where do we go from here? Put the lights down.
We're going shopping. We're going to go buy some.
Yeah, we need to get her a shirt that doesn't kill people.
He wanted to take my shirt home with him.
Okay, Steve, what's your number two?
Well, my number two is actually, I was thinking hard about it, but I only had a couple that I really liked, but I picked Iron Maiden. Yeah. Well, it's not because I like them.
It's not because you like them.
Got it. It's like, you know, I didn't buy a Maiden. I've never bought a Maiden record in my life. I mean, God bless the band. They're great.
So
and
why'd
stuff,
you pick them?
Well, because, you know, I remember when I was living in San Diego. I came back to L.A. here in 1980. And they were, like, everywhere. You know, it was like Leopard and the Almighty Priest and Maiden and a couple other bands. But Maiden, my guitar player lived with this girl. Maiden. End of story.
All right. Dave, what's your number two, bro?
It's all about Ozzy, Black Sabbath.
Oh.
Ozzy defines it all. I mean, Black Sabbath's stuck around. Look who's doing right now. A reunion tour. The guy still kicks ass. Every single band I've ever worked with that's heavy always mentioned Sabbath as their biggest influence. And one thing that Kurt Cobain always said was his biggest influence, Sabbath.
Really?
He said, I can't deny Black Sabbath. And then everything from then, since Kurt came on board, everything's been influenced after him, so.
Okay. All right, we're going to have to take a short break. When we come back, we're going to hear our panelists' first choices, and we're going to let our audience vote to determine the definitive top three list of the best heavy metal bands of all time. Stay with us. Have come today armed with their list of the top three choices for best heavy metal band. They'll continue to defend these choices, then our audience will make the final call by casting their votes for the best heavy metal bands of all time. So far, here's who our panelists have chosen. Rob chose Rage Against the Machine as his number three. Yeah. I'm down with that. And Metallica as his number two. Julie has gone with Kiss as her third pick. And Judas Priest as her second pick. Oh, that's so sweet. And Steven went with Motorhead as his third choice and Iron Maiden as his second.
Groupies are hot, aren't they? He likes their groupies.
They're hotter groupies.
Here, I'll shoot myself, okay?
All right, Davis that's picked AC/DC as his number three and Black Sabbath as his number two. All right, Rob, it's time for you to tell us, who is your number one choice?
He's already been there, but how come you didn't make him number one? Black Sabbath, for me, has always been number one.
No way,
always
man.
Been number one. Always been number one. They're my local hometown boys from Birmingham, England, which is where this strange accent comes from, if you can understand it. And like you were saying, you know, everything starts from an original source, and they were the originators of heavy metal music. When Ozzy got together with Geezer and Tony and Bill, they just made this special thing happen. Especially from what Tony does with the guitar. I mean, he just has that incredible tone, which he's never changed through all the years. It's always been there consistent. And then, of course, the craziest, most insane frontman in the world of rock and roll, Ozzy Osbourne, you know? Who else do you know has like bats for breakfast and dogs for lunch and God knows
bad
what else for dinner
least,
and
right?
lunch. But he's just a wild guy. But aside of all the antics, they just have the most incredible thing going for them. And everybody, the newer bands look towards Sabbath as a source, as an inspiration.
Okay.
So for me, numero uno.
Yeah. Black Sabbath.
Black all Sabbath.
Right. All right, Julie, what is your number one choice?
Okay, I have a good reason for it, but it's Poison.
Oh. Wait. Like Poison, I hate them. They're not
what?
A metal band. They're a pop band.
Okay, they're a soft metal band, but what they did
what
is they...
What is that? What is soft
they,
metal? Copper?
No, what they did
is... I plead the fifth.
They saved a half a generation that may have gone to pop, and they pulled them over into metal. Even if it's at the edge of metal, they saved that group of kids from being,
they
you know,
saved the group of kids? What are they,
yes.
Samaritans?
What are they
saving them from metal? What are you talking about? They were out there trying to get laid. They weren't trying to save kids.
I know.
Like, yeah, let's put some makeup on and have sex with some confused young girls. That's what they were doing.
Transvestites.
And they were going, yeah, let's save the kids from pop.
They didn't
let's
do
save them from Tiffany. Go, boys. We have a mission.
Kids who would have listened to Madonna and Mariah Carey, they ended up listening to a guy with a bandana and long hair and
Steve,
cereal.
Steve, what's your number one?
Well,
Mariah Carey.
I love her.
I do
too.
Please, Steve, you gotta be eclectic.
All right, you guys, please boo more for Julianne. No, I'm just. She's great.
What's your number one, dude?
My number one is Judas Priest, of course.
And you know, I just wanna hope that the checks. And I just hope the checks don't bounce when you try and cash them out.
See, Rob's gonna be writing checks for days.
No disrespect.
No, I mean, Judas Priest is the band. It's like I've, you know, when I would get into music and stuff, it was I was listening to it and trying to emulate and sing and et cetera, and it was, that's it. I mean, it was Judas Priest.
Okay, one. Dave, you're number one.
Led Zeppelin.
Yeah. The original.
I mean, come on.
No disrespect to Rob.
You picked Poison over Led Zeppelin?
Yeah, come on.
Led Zeppelin. This guy tried to rape me to Led Zeppelin, and I ran in from his house. He goes, "Don't you like that?" I'm like, "No."
Two Led Zeppelin.
He tried to put his hands down my pants, and I wasn't ready.
What's that? It's appropriate.
What song was he playing? So I don't like Led Zeppelin. I thought Long One, Stairway to Heaven, or something.
Led Zeppelin 2.
The Long One.
He tried to slip me the Long One during the Long
One. Oh God! Well, I know that you feel that some of these choices just don't cut it, folks. We're gonna take a look at the list and hear our panelists' suggestions for four choices that we can eliminate right now. Rob, let's start with you. If you had to eliminate somebody.
I got to eliminate.
Eliminate
the band
one.
With the most hair poison.
All right.
I have to go. I
gotta go. Who disagrees? Does anybody disagree with that?
No way.
All right, poison's just gone, dude. It's over.
That's
Julie.
Not metal. Wow.
Julie, if you were going to chop somebody off, who would you chop off?
I'm going to get rid of Iron Maiden. Just because.
All right.
Iron Maiden to me represents something that, you know, keeps people from having sex, so.
Everything is sex with you, you're a freak. Steve, who would you chop off the list?
I would have to say Kiss.
Yeah. Really? Oh, I love Kiss.
Well, why? Kiss isn't heavy, to me, Kiss is not heavy metal.
Kiss is a cartoon.
Dude, Kiss is a theatrical,
like
hard
the
rock band.
Dude, I love Kiss.
You know, and everybody talks about Kiss, the difference, hey. Like some people think Rat is heavy metal. We're not heavy metal. We are, I call us a hard rock band. You know, yeah. There is a difference to me. It's like, you say metal,
I'm so confused.
Priest, I think, you know.
But I love Kiss.
It is a dilemma.
I just talked to Paul Stanley this week.
Yeah, it is.
He's doing Phantom of the Opera. He's going to be doing Jekyll and Hyde. They do their own makeup. They are just the coolest guys.
What is this?
So
metal?
Nice.
I'm getting rid of Kiss.
Is it metal or is it not metal?
They go?
Is it
heavy metal?
Anybody who has a guitar that
plugged in, heavy metal. All right, they go.
It's sold out.
Dave.
I'm going to have to say I love Lemmy, but Motorhead, man.
Hey.
Pull him out.
I agree. Later with that. Okay. Let's take a look at the remaining list of choices during the commercial break. Our studio audience will be casting their votes, and when we come back, we will reveal the final, definitive list of the top three best heavy metal bands of all time. Stick around to see how your choices do. Please stay with us. Just really scared me. Welcome back to the list, folks. The moment has arrived. Our panelists have debated their choices. Our audience has cast their votes. We have created the ultimate top three list of the best heavy metal bands of all time. Before we announce the results, let's take a look at the final choices. Rage Against the Machine, Metallica, Black Sabbath, Judas Priest, AC/DC, and Led Zeppelin. Life's tough, kid. All right, drum roll, please. Here is the list of the best heavy metal bands of all time. Number three is Black Sabbath. Number two is Metallica. Led Zeppelin.
What can you do?
How cruel!
What can you do?
Well, first of all, at least
this audience ain't fixed, right? It's a legitimate choice.
I got a question about Led Zeppelin. Is Led Zeppelin heavy metal or is it just rock?
There you go. There's another shot to talk about. Led Zeppelin was the blueprint for all their heavy metal records. You need another shot to talk about what's metal and what's hard rock.
Yeah, it's so weird.
Robert Plant was the first guy to define heavy metal screaming. Jimmy Page, heavy metal riffs.
Yeah, but it's rock to like Stairway to Heaven. That's rock. That's not heavy
metal. That's rock.
That's
up a tune.
The Ocean. That's
heavy metal.
Absolutely. That's rock.
Well, the second, third record.
You cannot hate your parents and still like Zeppelin.
It was all about the color.
Yeah. That's why it's not metal.
Jimmy Page lived at Aleister Crowley's mansion in the middle of, like, the guy practiced black magic in the middle of nowhere.
Well, Black Sabbath, Metallica, and Led Zeppelin. That's it, folks. That's the choices.
Awesome choices.
I want to thank each of our panelists, our studio audience, and of course, you at home. I'm Joe Rogan. This is VH1, and we'll see you next time on The List. Take care. Bye-bye.
Santana, the number one band in the country with 8 brand new Grammys. And they're on Hard Rock Live, presented by Blue from American Express. Up next,